This is Dr. Gaurav Kumar and I welcome you all to my YouTube channel. Today we are going to discuss about how to calculate IC50 value using MS Excel. Many people who are doing pharmaceutical research, they need to calculate IC50 value in order to express their results in a better way. However, many people are really struggling to calculate IC50 value. In today's video, I will be discussing about process for calculation of IC50 value in a very easy way. So we will discuss the calculation of IC50 value with the help of an example. So the example is, we have treated the cancer cells with different concentrations of a drug and the resulting cytotoxic activity is mentioned below in the table. So we have used four concentrations, 10 micrograms, 20 micrograms, 40 micrograms and 80 micrograms, and the relative activities, percentage cytotoxic activities has been listed here in the table. Now R1, R2 and R3 is representing the three replicates. Mostly in biological data, it is good that we are repeating the experiment at least three times. So that is why we are taking an example where we have taken for each concentration at least three replicates. So now for calculation, we will be using the Excel. So I am moving to the Excel sheet. First thing you have to do is you have to arrange your data on the Excel sheet as you are seeing here. I've written the drug concentrations in the first column and in the second column, third column and fourth column, I've written the R1, R2 and R3, three replicates value. Here, this is the percentage activity of the drug against the cancer cells. Now, first thing which we have to do in this is, first we have to calculate the mean value as we have three replicates. So for this, it's very simple. We have to go to formula, then to mode function, then statistical, and here we will select the average. And once you have selected the average, you have to select the values for which you want to take the average. So I've selected the values and then I will click OK. And just by scrolling it down, I can calculate for all of them. So this is the calculated values. So once you have calculated the mean value, next thing you have to do is you have to create a XY scatter curve by using these values. So I'm going into the option of insert, then I'm selecting the XY scatter curve. I will get a blank page like this. So I will now right click on this and go to select data option. Then I will go to add. It is first asking me X values. So in X values, I will put the concentration. And in the Y value, I will put the mean which I have calculated, mean activity. And then I'll just click on OK. So that will give me this kind of graph. Once this graph is ready, if you want, you can put the Excel titles by clicking on this plus option here. Here we have different options. So we can go to Excel title here. And then here, if we want, we can write drug concentration. You can write in full. And here also we can write percentage cytotoxicity. So once our graph is ready, now what we have to do is we need to again go back to this plus option. We should go to this trend line, then to more options. Then you will get something like this. Here you can select linear and then go into the bottom and click on display equation on the chart and display R square value on the chart, and then you can close it. So as you can see here, you can see the equation and R square value. If your R square value is near to 1, as you can see, this value is very near to 1, that means your graph is linear and it is suitable pattern for making the calculating the IC50 value. Why? The equation you are getting is Y is equal to MX plus C. Sometimes you can also get Y is equal to MX minus C. So both possibilities are there. So this time we are getting Y is equal to MX plus C. As you can see, Y is unknown value, but here you need to remember we are calculating IC50 value. So Y is always going to be IC50. If you are calculating IC90, then Y will be 90. So because we are calculating IC50, Y will be 50. M value is already given in the equation. x value, that is the concentration where IC50 will be achieved. That we have to find out, and again you can see C value is given. So what we have to do, we can write this formula in the other way. As I have to find out x now, so I can put x is equal to y minus c divided by m. So this is the same thing, okay, this is the same formula, but this time I have written it as I want to calculate x value or IC50 value. Just suppose if your equation is this y is equal to mx minus c, then what you would have done, then also almost same thing, x is equal to y, this time it will be plus c divided by m. So both of them are having similar calculations, only difference is here we have minus and here y plus c, right? Now we have all the values, we'll put it into this formula. So first I will put the value of y, then c, y, then c, and then m, and what I have to find out, x. So I am putting the y value 50. I already told you why we are using 50. C value m x plus c, so c value is 9.8696. please don't leave any value even after the point, otherwise you won't get correct results. Then we have to put the value of m, and here the value of m is 0.4035. now what I have to do is I need to find out the value of x. So I'll come to this column or this portion and just click on the above this where we can write the equation. So I'm just starting with is equal to, then I'm putting starting a bracket, and in bracket I need to put what, y minus c. So the value of y is here, so I'm clicking on value of y, then I am putting a sign of minus, and then value of c, then bracket closed, sign of divided, and then value of m, and then enter. So this is what I am getting as IC50 value. 99.45 is IC50 value for this particular sample. Hope all of you might have understood this. If you like this video, please like this, subscribe to our channel, and share this video with your friends. Thank you all. You can post your queries in the comment box.